What's up, everybody? We are live!
I'm gonna give you a moment to do whatever it is that you feel you need to do to calm your body.
Some of us are afraid to speak, and some of us are yelling.
The policing profession is one of the most scrutinized professions.
They are tough and they're focused and they have to keep this, or they think they have to keep this persona.
Every person, no matter what society or education, has an idea of what justice should be.
You have to put yourself in a very vulnerable state.
See law enforcement as just people, not as a badge, not as a gun.
Wherever you are, make some noise!
Oh, that feels good. One more time. Oh, yeah.
Policing. Just saying the word can cause fierce debate. But whether you take a side on that debate or not, law enforcement, safety and security are a fundamental part of our society. Yet law enforcement itself is perhaps the most scrutinized profession in our society. What are the challenges we face today, the law enforcers and the rest of us? Well, there seem to be many, but there are also many people who are facing those challenges head on. And we spoke with one community determined to make a difference.
Everything that we do here is to build community. 4 years ago, 2016, there was a lot of drugs, a lot of prostitution here in this area.
Really?
We started the community garden. We started having classes on the community garden. We started raising awareness about this area. And then it started changing the entire area. There is a lot more influx of business. There's a lot more influx of investing.
What was it, do you think, that turned it around?
It's pride.
Ooh.
It's pride. We decided to start this here, have roots here. Just like when you put a seed into the ground and you make sure that you have enough pride to water it every single day and be there to cultivate it and help it grow. It's the same thing. We walked up these same streets to meet everybody in our community, not forcing them to be a part of it, but letting them know these opportunities are available if you're interested. We went from 4 kids and we blew up to 85 kids.
I love all these terms that you're using, you know, grow and roots and planting the seed and blossoming.
Absolutely. Me being a retired police officer, I understand that 90% of your job is serving the community. Mm. It's that 10% of protecting the community that police officers really hone in on. Mm. But there's, you know, we can do better. And being part of a community and growing the community from the inside out is what the Verde Eco School and the Hey Blue Initiative is all about.
John Verde is the founder of Hey Blue, an initiative that strengthens the ties between police and their community. And it kind of grew out of his community garden, literally.
I was doing a traffic stop, and the driver of that vehicle fled. And when he fled, he ran through the Verde Eco School community garden.
He didn't flee on foot, he fled.
Oh, he jumped out of the car and fled on foot.
Oh.
And he ran through, physically through the garden for the Verde Eco School, where John Verde was helping with a class. That's where I met John for the first time. And pretty quickly, he was running the initiative idea by me. And when he told me kind of the bigger picture of Hey Blue, I was absolutely interested in being a part of that, making sure that the police department was as well. And the initial rollout was the story time.
Keeping you safe.
You were doing some of that too?
Oh, absolutely. I've done it physically and virtually as much as possible. It's very enjoyable to do. And you'll find that, you know, law enforcement in general is made up from alpha human beings, right? They are tough and they can do the job and they're focused and they have to keep this, or they think they have to keep this persona. And you get them into a story time with kindergarten kids where you're singing songs, head, shoulders, knees and toes, and dancing around at a bubble party. some of the officers, including myself initially, in work mode, don't make that transition, but when it connects and when that 25 kid class, kindergarten class, is hugging on you and really enjoying you being there, you can tangibly see the change.
Does it change you from an alpha to something else for that for a short period of time?
I would say no. There's a portion of law enforcement, clearly, that we have to take into consideration and be aware of threats and be aware of things that, albeit infrequently happen, that we're looking out for, prepared for, but that doesn't mean that we can't connect. And very rapidly, it went intrastate. Then we were contacted by the lead hostage negotiator for the country of India, who wanted to be a part of the program, and Anish is part of the program, and it went international at that point. And we have some folks that have been part of the program since the beginning that were in California that are now in East Africa.
So you spent 30 years in law enforcement. How important is this initiative now as opposed to how important was it 30 years ago?
It's always been important. To your point, I think there's no longer an option of opting in to be involved or not. It's absolutely imperative for a variety of reasons, 2020 being one of them.
2020 was a year like no other. In my over 32 years in law enforcement, I can tell you that policing changed tremendously. And what changed was a sentiment about law enforcement, the scrutiny that law enforcement practices and policies came under. What stayed the same for us was, and what we focused on, was our relationship with our community.
David Gillespie is the current chief at the Melbourne Police Department, and he's determined to keep on growing community relations.
I see the uniform or something, and I think of enforcement.
Enforcement is one piece of what the police do, and if you look at throughout history, that's what you really see on TV is the enforcement aspect. But people don't understand really what we're asked to do. And many times law enforcement's role has changed over time, and it gets mixed messages, and there can be a lack of support. And for the officers, they feel people don't understand what it is that they have to do and the challenges they face every day. It's a very difficult job that we ask police officers to do, and it's very dangerous. I think the community would say a similar thing, that law enforcement doesn't understand my story. Law enforcement doesn't understand my challenges, and they don't understand the things that I've had to face that have put me in the position that I'm in today.
Does it make your job easier or more effective when you have better community relations?
Absolutely. What these programs do in the community relations is it opens people's minds to another perspective to help us better understand one another so that we actually can move forward with a better knowledge of what the other person's facing. Because when we know each other and we know their challenges, we have a little bit more patience and a little bit more presence to be able to try to help one another. And we talk about some difficult issues that a lot of times go ignored.
What do you think happens when those conversations take place?
It's a transformation. Hey Blue is that facilitator of that conversation and discussion to really talk about some tough, meaningful issues on race relations and law enforcement practices. We might be a small spot on the map in the city of Melbourne, but what we're trying to do is get it right.
No, I'm not driving. This is my first time riding in a police car.
By just talking to a few police officers, I learned more in one day about law enforcement than I had learned watching perhaps hundreds of cop shows and movies over many years.